Today, I have an Illustrator tutorial where we're going to be designing this funky 3D shape. It's a little more advanced than a beginner level tutorial, and it's quite long, so strap yourself in and let's dive into this Illustrator funky 3D tutorial. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. A quick disclaimer, I do not own this design because I drew inspiration from Instagram. I'm simply showing you guys how to generate such a 3D design in today's Illustrator tutorial. The first thing we need to do is to generate a letter for our funky 3D shape. Choose something quite blocky and square. The font I'm using is called Future Socialism if you want to download it from the internet. With the letter selected, create the outlines like so. This will turn the font letter into an actual vector shape. For some reason, this font has an anomaly here, but that's easily tidied up with the direct selection tool by manipulating the anchor points. We now need to distort the letter perspective by going up to Distort and Transform, and then Free Distort. Play around with the four anchor points until the letter looks like mine. And this is going to really help the 3D shape effect in today's tutorial. Position the letter on your canvas and then lock it in place so it doesn't move around. Select the stroke and then using the pen tool, draw a line exactly along the left-hand side of the letter shape. Lock that line in place because we're going to need it a little later. And then draw a line from the top right corner that will dictate the direction of the stretched part of the 3D shape. Change the color of the stroke on the line to something visible over the top of the letter. And then using the Alt Option key, duplicate it several times on each corner, carefully placing exactly on the point of the corner. Unlock everything and then systematically lock down the blue lines and the letter, leaving only the line that we just drew along the left-hand side not locked. Position it around this distance from the letter and then take the pen tool. You can hover the pen tool over one end of the line and then continue the path and carefully draw it around to complete the shape. Flick the stroke over to a color fill on the shape, and then take the direct selection tool to tidy up any imperfections. You can take your time here to make sure that everything is nice and flush between the new shape and the letter, because it needs to be perfect. We then simply hold down the Alt Option key and duplicate this shape like so. Try and position the shape as best as you can, and then unlock everything. Delete all of the blue lines apart from the bottom one so we can see what we're doing. From here, keep using the Alt Option key to duplicate the 3D part of the design, and then use the Direct Selection tool to tidy up things perfectly. Your Illustrator funky 3D shape should look like mine here. You now need to locate the swatch libraries if you follow me, and then open up the cool color swatches. We can now select each individual section of the 3D shape and then click a color in the swatch library. The idea is to put colors side by side that match and run in a visually pleasing order. So as you can see here, my 3D shape goes from very light purple through kind of blue hues up to light green, which looks pretty funky. With nothing selected in Illustrator, take white in the color palette, and then using the pen tool, add a shape along the side like so. This is going to act as a highlight, so lower the opacity of the white shape to act like a highlight, which looks pretty neat. A quick tip, if you turn on the snap to point function in Illustrator, you will find a lot of this tutorial to be easily accurate. We can then lock everything so it doesn't move around through the tutorial. Again, using the pen tool, we can add a very light shadow on either side of the highlight. Add a gradient to the shape, and then add black on both sides of the gradient, with one side being set to zero opacity. You can then also lower the overall opacity to ensure the shadow blends in well. Do the same on the other side of the highlight with the same method as we previously used for the shadow. Once you've done that, lock everything in place. We're a little bit over halfway now, folks. There are two ways to make the next shape in this tutorial. The first way is to take the pipette tool and select the first color on your design, making sure you don't select the shadow or the highlight. The rounded rectangle tool can be used if you click the artboard and then type in the measurements to determine. This is where you're going to need to tap into the artistic flair that you have. Using white and the pen tool, draw in lines along the shape that's going to act as lighting and highlights. You can use the Gaussian blur effect to soften the line and then even lower the opacity if you need to. All also, use the ellipse tool to make white circles and then add a Gaussian blur to them also. Keep adding circles and lines using this technique and method to build up your 3D realistic shape. As you can see, I've also added a dark line to indicate shadow at the bottom. Duplicate the cylinder shape in case you want to use it later, and then select all of the effects in the initial shape, and then hit Command or Control G to group them together. Now position the 3D cylinder shape in place, and you can duplicate this shape over and over for the rest of your design. Take a dark color as a stroke, and then use the pen tool to make a line that's going to act like a shadow. This method can be used to make the cylinder shapes as well, and I think it's the best way. Bump up the stroke weight, and then open up the stroke window, because we want to round off the ends of the stroke, and then add a Gaussian blur. In the transparency window, change the blend mode to something like overlay or hard light. This will help it blend a lot better into the 3D shape, and also lowering the opacity if need be. If you select the group together shapes, bring it to the front so the shadow is behind it, adding to the 3D effect. You can then add anchor points to the shadow stroke, and then take the direct selection tool to bend the shadow over the corner of the 3D shape. Go ahead and duplicate the cylinder shapes, ungroup them, and change the color of the main shape to match the 3D shape it's behind. So as you can see here, I've used the pipette tool to select the purple color. You can add a background to your 3D shape in today's Illustrator tutorial, so open up the gradient window and generate a gradient similar to mine. Then take the rectangle tool and make a shape, sending it to the very back afterwards. You can change the direction of the gradient and make sure it's a linear, not a radial gradient. As you can see here, this is looking pretty funky, but carry on taking your time to make the cylinder shapes, paying close attention to the lighting and the shadow effects with the Gaussian blurs and the opacity changes. So here's my final design. One cool funky 3D shape in today's Illustrator tutorial, brought to you by Satori Graphics. Again, I don't take credit for this design. I saw a similar design on Instagram, and I wanted to use it as inspiration for you guys in this tutorial. Let me know what you thought of today's video in the comment section, and remember to like and share my content if you do find it useful. Subscribe for 4 weekly graphic design uploads if you haven't done already. And until next time, design your future today. Peace.